How's it going, guys? It's the man, the myth, the legend, Quad MFT here, bringing you a really impressive gameplay. And if you guys don't recognize this map already, this is the 6v6 team deathmatch named Cargo. I really, really like Cargo. You rarely see any gameplay of it on YouTube, considering it is a 6v6 team deathmatch map. But the gun that I'm using in this gameplay is the Scorpion Evo submachine gun. And you know, I really, really like the Scorpion Evo. A lot of people don't really like it, but I really, really like it. The attachments that I'm using on it, I am using the wild card that lets you have three attachments. The attachments that I'm using are the suppressor, the grip, and the fast mags. Now, the reason why I'm using the suppressor is, of course, to stay off the radar, which also goes hand in hand with the ghost perk. Then I'm also using the grip to reduce the recoil and kick. If you guys didn't know, there's a ton of recoil and a ton of kick on this gun. And then I'm using the fast mag to reload faster. Reloading faster really helps me a lot in a lot of the different situations. So what I thought I'd talk about today is how to get nuclear. So today I'm going to be teaching you guys all the tips, all the tricks, and all the little different maneuvers on how I like to get a lot of nuclears. So what I like to do is to make sure you're running the right score streak. So the score streaks that I like to run while going for a lot of nuclears is the UAV, the orbital VSAT, and the EMP. Now the reasoning behind why I like to use the UAV is because it tells me where the enemies are at if they're not using ghosts. I also really, really like the orbital VSAT. The orbital VSAT is like an upgraded UAV times 4 billion. And then the EMP, you know when you get EMP'd, everybody hates it, so do I, so that's why I like to EMP my enemies. So I'm sure you guys can tell how much score streaks actually make a difference, but what else I'm going to be telling you guys is the type of guns you're going to use. And the class setup really makes a huge difference, so the guns you guys are going to want to use is probably a submachine gun. Submachine guns really, really seem to be overpowered in Black Ops 2. I really like them just because they're so mobile, they have a lot of ammo in the clip, and they deal out a lot of damage, especially with their range and their rate of fire. They're overall great guns. I'd suggest for beginners to start off with the PDW or the MSMC, maybe the MP7 if you're a little bit more advanced, but once you can get past those guns, you can do basically anything. Maybe try and go for a sniper nuclear, an assault rifle, light machine gun, whatever it is, guys, just try out the submachine guns. They're absolutely great guns. Now the reason why I chose to use the Scorpion on Cargo was because I knew that Cargo was a really, really close quarters map. What you've got to do also when going for nuclears is make sure to match up your gun, your game mode, and your playstyle to use the type of gun and the type of map that you guys are think you're going to do the best on. That's why I chose the Scorpion Evo for Cargo. I mean, what better gun to use on Cargo than the Scorpion Evo? I mean, the Scorpion Evo has such great hip fire, such little recoil when you rock the grip, guys. You have to rock the grip, but that's what I'm trying to communicate to you guys. Make sure to choose the right gun for the right map and the right game mode and your right play style. Another cool thing about nuclears is they're a lot of fun to get, guys. They're so much fun, but one more thing about nuclears is you can get them in any game mode. Whether you guys like to play 6v6 team deathmatch like me, or you like to play domination, maybe you like to play hardcore capture the flag, I don't know you. Maybe you like to play one of the chamber gun game, whatever it is, guys, you can pull off a nuclear in any of those game modes. I just thought that was really cool because there's been certain game modes where you can't do certain things, and I really like that about the nuclear. If you guys didn't know already, your score streaks do not count towards your nuclear streak. You have to get 30 kills with your gun in a row, which in my opinion is pretty gosh dang impressive. Another really cool quick tip is you definitely want to have a great class loadout. What I mean by great class loadout is you're probably not going to go on those huge gun streaks like you need for nuclears if you're not using a lot of perks. So the perks that you guys are going to want to use is Ghost, Scavenger, Toughness, and Dexterity. If you guys can use all four of those perks, you guys will do immensely better. If you guys enjoyed these tips or just this video in general, remember to give me a big thumbs up down below. Those always help me out a ton. And if I could ask one little small thing from you guys, if you could go and follow me on Twitter or like my Facebook page, that's where you guys are going to go and interact with me the most. I'm pretty sure most of you guys have Facebooks, but if we could try and hit 125 likes on this video, you guys would be the coolest cats in town. If you guys haven't subscribed already, you should, because you'll be able to get all my updates. I upload daily. It's been QuadMFT, and I'll see you next time.